Hello everyone. In this video, I will introduce to you a unique set of pliers called screw extractors or screw extracting pliers. This is the engineer PZ-59 Neji Saurus RX screw extractor. This is made in Japan. What makes it unique is that it can do a very specific function quite easily that other kinds of pliers cannot. As the name implies, that function is extracting screws, particularly rusted screws, stripped off slotted heads, and generally any kind of screw that cannot be removed with a screwdriver so long as it can fit in its jaws. To better appreciate this, let's examine first the gripping surface of an electrician's pliers. This is a client tool's pair of lineman's pliers. Notice that its gripping surface has crisscross serrations. This design is very good for gripping and pulling materials in various directions. This other one is a pair of Inco combination pliers. Notice that its gripping surface has parallel serrations or teeth. Just like the client tools, this is designed for gripping and pulling, like pulling off the insulator in a conductor. When it comes to gripping and pulling insulators or twisting wires, these electrician's pliers are perfect. However, when it comes to removing screws, the electrician's pliers are not very effective. It is not their fault, of course, as they are not designed for this purpose. But just for the sake of illustration, here's a screw. When we use the electrician's pliers to grip and turn it, for example, the serrations will just slide along the head of the screw. There is no traction strong enough to turn the screw, especially if it is rusted or worn out. The screw extractor, on the other hand, looks just like an electrician's pliers. It has handles, jaws, pivot, and cutting knives. But what sets it apart is its gripping surfaces. First off, notice that the teeth of this screw extractor perfectly mesh or interlock with each other. So for example, if you want to grip a thin flat material, like a sheet metal, these interlocking teeth provide an excellent grip. The gripping surface of the screw extractor, as you can see, is designed to provide maximum traction and powerful grip. It has a groove running down the middle with vertical serrations. It has horizontal teeth, whose edges here, this edge, provide sharp points that bite into the head of the screw. As a result, the head of a screw is held on tight in a very powerful force, allowing you to turn the screw with minimum of effort. The tool does the hardest part of the work for you. We can also see here at the tip of the jaws how the screw extractor works. I have another screw extractor, the engineer PZ-65, designed like a vice grip. This is made in Taiwan. It has fewer vertical serrations than the PZ-59, but it performs the same function of extracting screws with the added convenience of locking on the jaws, allowing you to concentrate your effort on the turning action. Here is an example of a screw with worn out head that a screwdriver cannot turn it already. I'll use my vice grip screw extractor to try and turn the screw. My vice grip screw extractor has successfully loosened the screw. I will just retighten it. Now the screw on top is partially sunk in the frame holder. But the thing about this screw extractor is that even if just a tiny bit of material is exposed, the screw extractor can bite it and still turn it loose. So the screw extractor has loosened this partially sunk screw. The screw extracting pliers or screw extracting vice grip may not be a tool that you use regularly, but when you do encounter that annoying rusted screw, or a screw with stripped off head that cannot be removed with a screwdriver, you'll be glad to have these engineers around. For me, I reserved them strictly for screw extracting, and they did not disappoint. Thank you for watching.